Assalamu alaikum. I'm gonna make this really quick. Anyone who knows me knows I'm a big advocate of self-defense for women, especially for Muslim women, and that's because they're perceived as an easy target, and the kind of men who attack women tend to go for easy targets. Now, because of cultural misconceptions, a lot of men believe Muslim women to be weak, and you know what? Rightfully so, unfortunately, because cultures, a lot of cultures, particularly Arabian and South Asian cultures, tend to teach women that it's not ladylike to be able to fight and so on. Recently, a sister was killed in Essex. May Allah rest her soul. Inna lillahi wa inna lillahi raji'un. And the only reason it's made the news is because the sister was killed. But every single day in London, hundreds of women suffer microaggressions and all-out, you know, attacks because of the way they're dressed. And I think that it's disgusting. I'm disgusted because, number one, there's Muslim men saying, oh, she shouldn't have been out by herself, which is retarded, I believe. Any man who says that to me face to face is going to get a slap. I don't care who you are, even if you're an imam. How dare you blame a woman for her own being, you know, for her own harassment? So women have to go out. Women have to do things, whether they work or their house, you know, their housewives, they have the right to go out and not be harassed, just as they did in the time of the Prophet Muhammad, peace and blessings be upon him. I think that when Lee Rigby's killers were all over the news, Anjum Chowdhury was blamed, and you know, rightfully so. The same way, Paul Golding is a criminal. Paul Golding has radicalized white English working class people and Islamophobes, and he's made it okay to attack Muslims. Since Britain First has come about and sprung onto the scene into infamy, loads of people have made it, you know, finally gotten even more courage to attack Muslims, especially the women. So I would, you know, I demand for this video to be shared, and I want people to understand that Britain First is a terrorist organization. They are a radical organization. They have gone into mosques, they've kicked down doors, they threatened Muslims, they put up Islamophobic rhetoric on their page and people like it and share it. And now this is, you know, this is the result, this is a manifestation, and things will only get worse. If it was a bunch of Muslims doing this and posting it, going to mosques and going to churches and attacking people, and then members of that group went and killed somebody on the street, they would, you know, they would face prison time and so on. Britain First should be monitored by the police. And Paul Golding is a terrorist and should be arrested because he has incited hatred. He should be in Belmarsh right now. You know, I'm sick and tired of the double standard. Theresa May is a hypocrite because if Britain First was a Muslim group, these boys would be, you know, thinking about getting their citizenship stripped from them, as she said. Theresa May has not turned up to any Muslim communities and apologized for all the aggressions that have been heaped on us. And when Muslims do retaliate, and there will be retaliations because it's coming too much, when Muslims start retaliating, you know, it's going to be terrorism then. What about now? This is terrorism. This is a hate crime. And I'm sick of it. And I think Muslims need to get up. Wake up, okay? Start learning to defend yourselves. Walk around prepared. Especially if you look Muslim. You know, I don't have to worry because I'm black, okay? But if you're Asian, I don't care if you're Sikh. If you look the wrong color, wear a turban, wear a hijab, wear an abaya, and you walk around in public, you need to learn to protect yourself. You need to stay prepared within the law. I'm not saying go and carry a gun, don't hold that against me, and I'm not saying go around attacking people randomly, but be prepared to take, you know, be prepared to take extreme measures and understand how violence works, and be prepared to use it if somebody uses it against you simply because of how you look. Learn to disarm a knife, learn to use one, learn to hurt a person, learn pressure points, learn something. Do not walk around thinking that we are safe, because we are not. If you look like a Muslim and you're in an area that is predominantly white, I'm sorry, but you are not safe. And you know, I'm not trying to drum hatred, but I'm sick of this. So please, share this video, tell people to wake up. This happens every single day. I can list nine underneath this video, nine times that this sort of thing has happened. And nobody has done anything because you're lulled into a false sense of security, thinking that the police will help you. Police only come when the crime has already been arrived, has already, you know, been committed. So do not rely on the police. They're just there to come and clean up the body after your life has been taken. Do not leave your safety in anybody else's hands. Do not leave yourself at anyone else's mercy. Learn to protect yourself. Be vigilant and be streetwise, okay? Please share this video. And I demand that Paul Golding is held responsible for this, because Paul Golding is a hate preacher. Paul Golding is a terrorist. And Paul Golding now is a murderer, because he is directly responsible for this sort of nonsense. And he should also be held for all the vandalizing of mosques that have taken place in his name. It's the angriest video I've done, and I'm sick of it. I'm a Muslim man, I have a Muslim wife. I am sick of having to worry about her when she's out by herself because some stupid Islamophobe has seen an easy target. Please, share this video. Paul Golding is a criminal. Salam.